This year actually marks 49th year for Cornell NanoScale Facility, and luckily for CNF, we've been continuously funded by National Science Foundation from the beginning. And federal support has been critical in maintaining the operation of CNF. Cornell NanoScale Facility is a user facility that enables nanofabrication and nanoscience for Cornell researchers as well as external users, both academia and industry.
CNF is kind of like the nano machine shop, I would say. In physics and engineering research, we've always had to make things, right? CNF is the way that we make things that are small. They're an essential toolkit for this research.
So lots of startup companies need advanced experimental tools that range between $100,000 to $1 million tools to be able to develop their prototypes. And you can't really go to places to do that. And CNF is a one-stop shop where they can do from the beginning to the end of the prototyping development.
Private industry and academic research are quite different. So private industry is focused on building a product that they can use to make money. They do not have the luxury of thinking deeply, expanding human knowledge, and exploring new ideas as thoroughly as an academic research environment has the ability to do. And so they're looking to us to create new ideas.
Running a user facility costs a lot of money, even though we all take it for granted. With the federal and state funding, let's say gone, which we don't want to imagine, then there are two outcomes. One is that we'll have to increase user rates substantially because quite a bit of the operation budget of CNF relies on federal and state grant. If we do not increase user rates, then we have to reduce the services that we offer, or we have to reduce the capabilities that we maintain right now. And this will adversely affect Cornell PI's research and their competitiveness in the research landscape, as well as the local economy, because the startup companies that rely on CNF for their product development will no longer be able to do that.
These user facilities have so many benefits, it's hard to explain them all at once. But one of them is that it makes things possible that individuals can't do by themselves. And that's really the key point. That has the effect of democratizing science. So having a shared user facility makes all kinds of things possible in a very economical way. It's actually money very well spent.
So if infrastructure like CNF are not supported, those early exploratory work, high risk, high reward type of work that VCs are not going to fund will be in jeopardy. And that is tied to not only economic prosperity, but also national security. Of course, funding agencies have to look at how their federal dollars are spent and whether taxpayers benefit from that. So National Science Foundation actually looked at what is the return on the federal dollar in supporting shared facilities. And actually the return on dollar was more than tenfold. Any support in early product development and basic science at the end is translated to commercial products that help us, the taxpayers.